सर अनम्यूट सर।
Hello. Good afternoon, everybody. Now we have sufficient participants. Those who are having mainly this problem with ERP updation of the budget, I hope everybody joined. I thank Ms. Monica for coming forward for explaining how to do that for the benefit of IHR scientists. I thank her, and now I request her to go ahead with how to make this entry of this project provisions in ERP and along with budget, and how to update that budget when we reach the new financial year, that is in the month of April, for drawing salaries of the temporary staff. With this small introduction, I request Monica to go ahead with her presentation. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Monica. I'll be discussing two things. First, the new project creation and its budget entry. And second, the updation of budget after one financial year. Okay, so we'll begin with new project creation. Okay, just let me share the screen. Sir, actually, you have to enable.
Yeah, okay, I'll be doing that. Yes, right. So now I will be making you as a host. Okay. Please unmute yourself, Ms. Monica. Please unmute. Now I'm making you as a host, and just give me a permission for recording. It may ask you to give permission for recording, so that it will be help for us for recording if it is asking. Okay.
Okay.
So please. Please go ahead.
Okay. Is the screen visible now?
Yeah, it is visible.
Okay. So the responsibility, I'm using ISRI Institute, but for your institute, the responsibility will be IIHR projects. Okay.
Okay.
For new project creation, you have to first click on project details. This window will open up and you have to click on new document. This is for new project creation. New document, three options will pop up. Create RPPI, copy from existing document, create new status report. For every project, you have to use the first option, create RPPI. Okay, then you have to click on next. Then it will ask for the type of project. You can select if it is externally funded, some consultancy project, or if there is no institute project, or you can use the first option for every project. That is not a problem at all. Okay, so I'll use the first option. Okay. Now you have to put the start date of the project. I'll put. Okay. Then finish. Okay. This screen will open up. Two things are important. First, end date of the project, and second, title of the project. Any expected end date you can put here. After that, later on, we can extend the date. Okay. I'll put 31st March 2022. 2022 and project title. After this, you have to click on the fourth tab, the last tab. This is project team info, doc approval. Okay. And here in employee, you have to enter the PI and co-PI's detail. Okay. First thing that is very important, for every new project you create, it is to be created from the PI's ERP ID only. No other ERP ID you will use. Otherwise, the PI cannot update the budget. Okay. So here you will put the PI's name, select role, and start date and end date will be same which we have put earlier. Okay. In the next line, you can add the co-PI's details. I'll add one. And then you have to save this yellow button, or you can use Control S. Only after updating the PIs and co-PIs detail, you have to save the project. If you save before this, then there is a problem in budget entry. Only after the updation of PIs and co-PIs details, you have to save the project. After saving this, you have to again click on project header, the first tab. It will show a pop-up, just press OK.
Yeah, it's just, as you are the host, if somebody is asking for entry, kindly admit.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, by the time it is, okay, this is done. This is the project number 1012948. This is the most important thing for every issue you have in the project. Any issue you face in the project, you have to tell this project number, this 7-digit number, 1012948. Okay. One issue that sometimes occurs, this project number does not generate. So what PIs do, they generate multiple projects. They don't have to do this. If you are not able to generate the project number, just let us know. We'll generate the project number for you. Okay. Is there any query till now?
And then this, what is the name of this project number? ERP?
The EFS number is, this is the highlighted one, 1012948.
Yeah, every time our office will be asking, you tell the 7-digit number. This 7-digit number is the standard project number.
Yeah, if there is any issue in the project, you have, the PI has to tell this number.
Okay.
Okay. And please, no need to share the passwords of your ERP IDs. Without password also, we can access your IDs.
Okay. Now you need only this project number.
Only this project number.
Okay, right.
And only PI's ERP ID, and that is also only in the case where PI details are not updated properly. Two things, project number and PI's ERP ID. That's it.
That's it. Remaining, you will help in updating.
Yeah.
Any problem. Right.
Okay, this project number is generated. I'll just note it down. I'll close this. This also. Now we have to enter the project budget. The option is enter budget. You'll put the project number you have generated. Click on second line. Project name will appear automatically. Okay. Then budget type. For every time you have to select expenditure budget. Okay. Once you select expenditure budget, small window will open up asking for fund type, scheme code and division. Fund type is 801 for every externally funded project. Okay. And if it is ICR project, then it is 201.
Okay.
Okay. Scheme code is the name of the funding agency. So I'll use 4DBT, 4003. Okay. And division is the PI's division. If it is not there, you can mail to add the division name. Otherwise, you can select default. I'll select plant pathology and press OK. After that, you have to click on details. Three options are there: capital, general, salaries. Most of the time, the PIs have the bifurcation of the budget. For example, they have some amount in equipments, then research, then for salaries, like that. Okay. So we'll put it in one head only, say general. Click on general, budget lines. Okay. Okay. Here we have to select the head's name first. There are multiple heads. You can select as per your requirement. I'll be selecting research expenses. Okay. Click on amount type, it will come automatically. Okay. Now you have to enter the budget in the financial year, in the current financial year, that is from April 21 to March 2022. Okay. So I'll add 1 lakh rupees and save. Three lines will automatically appear. That is not a problem. Okay. This is all for new project. We'll add one more head. Okay. Let's say we'll have TA. Amount type will come automatically. And 50,000. Save. Okay. One thing. Anything you update in this enter budget form, every time you have to click on submit and baseline. Without that, the changes will not reflect in the bill section.
Okay.
After entering these heads and budget, you have to close this form. The total will appear here, what you have entered. Okay. Total of all these three. Close this also. Press OK, submit, and baseline. The status right now is in progress. Just after 5-7 minutes, it will automatically come to working. And after that, the bill section can view the budget. Okay. One problem is also there when PI tries to enter the project budget. They can enter update the budget only when the status is working. Any other status will not allow the PI to enter the budget. The fields will be disabled if it is anything other than working. So I'll close this. Is there any query in the new project creation and budget entry?
If anybody has some clarifications, kindly ask. Okay, we'll proceed. Mainly, how to update. Now, immediate question is how to update in the new financial year.
Yeah, sure. Okay. When you
sir, I have one query.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let Raghu, please.
Yes, sir, please ask.
What is software requirement? Because we, every time we try, yeah, that okay. is the only, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that is basic thing. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah. Mozilla Firefox version 50.0.1.
It works only with Firefox Mozilla 15.1 yeah. version, correct?
It works on Internet Explorer only, but then there is a problem of downloading the project reports because it does not support Excel sheets to download. So best is to use Mozilla Firefox, and the version is 50.0.1. Anything higher than this will ERP will not work.
Okay, it is 50.01.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Right.
50.0.1.
Okay, right.
This you have to install, and one thing the major problem is there sometimes there is a pop-up to update the Mozilla version. You don't have to update this. If you update, it will go to higher version, and then again the ERP will not work. If there is any pop-up, just press cancel or ignore this. Okay.
Sir, is there one more clarification at this juncture? Is there any limitation for using the Office software or Windows? This one, somebody was telling that only Windows 10 and above will work for this. Is it correct?
No, no. It is not like this. Only Mozilla Firefox version 50.0.1 is the
only requirement.
Is important.
Okay.
Yeah. Shall we begin with the update part?
Okay, please.
I'll use the previously created project. You have to, okay. Okay, let me just tell you. When the PIE finds for the previously created project to update the budget, one problem that comes, all these yellow fields that is visible right now are disabled. They are all gray. This comes only when the project has reached its end date. In that case, the end date has to be extended. After that, only the PI can update the budget.
This is mainly whenever you get to the extension of the project.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
For example, many of the projects has been end dated on 31st March 2021. So if any PI tries to open budget form for that project, all the fields will be grayed out. Instead of yellow, everything will appear gray. Okay. After extension, they can update the budget. Just like this, they have to find the project, press OK. Details. And for we have okay, I'll update for one head, for example. Now what they have to do, two things are there after every financial year. They have new budget, or they want to carry forward the budget from last year. Okay, so if it is new budget, very simple, from this forward arrow they have to move first to the current financial year. This April 21. Okay. They have to enter the budget in the middle line, the raw cost line, and save. This is for the new budget they have. And now for carry forwarding the last year's budget, what they have to do, they have to first use this backward arrow and move to the month where they have entered the budget. Okay. Then they have to click on the middle line of this. For example, we are doing for operational expenses. So I'll click on operational expenses, the middle line. The moment they click on this, a small window will open up that will show the expenditure amount of that year and the funds available of that year. Okay. So I'll just note it down. Just wait.
I think this situation comes, suppose when our project started, example, August 2020, it is up to July 2021. In that case, this is valid, right?
Yeah. Sometimes the project starts from March 20, say most any project started from 1st March 2021. So they the PIs are not able to utilize the budget. So they can shift the budget from March to April. Because after every financial year, whatever you have entered in previous financial year is equivalent to zero. You have to update the budget to current financial year.
Okay, right.
Okay, so what you have to do, you have to, okay, I'll just do this again. For whatever head you want to carry forward the budget, you have to first move to the month where you have entered the budget. For example, here, the budget is entered in October 20. Okay, then you have to click on the head's name, middle line. Okay. The moment you press the head's name, there comes a window which tells you the expenditure of that head, which is 1514734, and funds available in that head, 335266. Okay, just note both these amounts. Okay, now what the PI have to do? PI have to remove the budget which he has, which he had entered in previous financial year. I'll remove this, okay? And he has to enter here the expenditure, which right now we noted from the small window that popped up, okay? Which is in our case is 1514734 for both the lines, raw cost and NA. This is important to maintain the expenditure amount. If even a single rupee is less than the expenditure amount, the project will go in rejected status. Okay. Here, there are two things. First, there was some expenditure. Then we have maintained here 1514734. In some cases, there is no expenditure, zero expenditure, and the budget they entered in last financial year is as it is available for current to carry forward. In that case, they don't have to enter anything. They just have to remove the budget from previous year and save. Okay, I have entered the expenditure amount. Now move to current financial year. And here you have to enter what that was available, which is 335266 on our case. Okay. This much is to be done for to carry forward the budget from last year to current financial year. Is there any query regarding this?
Okay, because this is very important. Those who have any clarifications, us.
In the sense, every time we have to split the whole budget into expenditure and available budget, we have to carry forward only the available budget to the next financial year.
Yes, sir. Only the available budget to the current financial year, and the expenditure amount is to be entered in previous financial year.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Any other query?
One more query.
Yeah.
Every month there is an expenditure is there. So will it automatically update the available balance?
Yes, sir. It will automatically update the available balance. You don't have to do. You don't have to do that part. You only have to enter the budget which you want to utilize. That's it.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other queries?
Any other query?
Madam, I have one query. This budget utilization, if we are not able to know the exact head spent, we can make it correction later also, no?
Yes, ma'am, you can do it, do the corrections later on. But the problem is, once you enter the budget and if there is any expenditure, you cannot remove the expenditure amount. For example, I have entered 1 lakh rupees and out of that 20,000 I utilized. So that 20,000 you cannot move from operational. 80,000 you can move anywhere.
Okay.
Okay. So that's why I suggest PIs to enter the exact amount, because sometimes what the bill section do, they by mistake use some other project or head, then budget gets booked and then it's get difficult to then the adjustment is difficult. There is a there is a solution for adjustment, but that is a difficult part.
Okay.
Any other?
Any other? This what we are seeing, this Oracle. Oracle is a part of that Mozilla Firefox. In the system, it asked first you download Oracle. How to understand that?
No, you don't have to. Okay, for the very first time when you download Mozilla, install Mozilla, for the very first time, it will ask for an OXE file to download and install. That is only the first time job. After that, you don't have to do it.
Okay.
Right. Madam, no need of Java, because sometimes it asks Java.
No, you don't have to. Only the, you have to install the Mozilla version 50.0.1 and that you have to, when you download the OXE file, that updates the Java. That does the work for you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, only thing is in control panel where there is Java option, you have to enter the that URL, ICRERP URL in that part, then only it will work.
Please show me, ma'am, that one, because...
Yeah, sure. Just give me a minute.
Dr. Gautam, you be thorough. If you have any doubt, we will contact you locally.
Yeah, sure. Okay, is there any query regarding the budget updation?
No, things like we should be very like know what exactly we have used and all these things. That will be, we will be knowing through the middle that one.
I have one query, ma'am.
Yeah.
Last year, whatever we have unspent balance, we'll be entering now. After few months, we'll be getting some more fund allotted for this year.
Yeah.
So then we can go for update as on that date what we have received under heads.
Yeah, sure. Just for example, you get the new budget in September July. 21.
Okay.
So you have to simply move to September 21 and enter the budget.
Okay.
Okay. Even if you don't want to move to September 21, you can add the budget in any month of this financial year. It will add up and show you.
Okay, that will be under raw cost only.
Yeah, under raw cost, you have to enter the budget.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Any other query?
Is it okay? Any, no clarifications? No further clarifications means you feel? Who are attended, we can confidently do it. Otherwise, anyhow, Ms. Monika is there for helping our phone also.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, okay. Any last question, anything? That Prakash Patil, sir, you are here?
Madam, that's what we are asking. That
sir please, is in other download, meeting, sir.
Okay. Please download that version, sir.
Yeah, sure.
That show me. Yeah.
Okay, I'll submit baseline this. If any query, just let me know. I'll share the screen again. Okay. Okay. Is the control panel screen visible to you?
Yeah, it is visible. Yeah.
Okay. Here, in programs, there comes a Java option. Okay. You have to open it.
Either it is 32 or 64, no difference.
32 bit. Okay, yeah, you have to download Mozilla version 50.0.1, 32 bit.
32 bit, okay.
Okay. Under this window, under this Java window, there is security. And in security, using edit site list, you have to enter this URL. Then only it will work.
$30,000 per month.
Hello, sir. Is the screen visible to you?
Yeah, it's visible. It is visible. Oh,
no, only Java.
Java 32 bit. Next step has not.
Okay, and here under security, you have to enter the URL of ICR ERP, and after that, it will work.
Can you say, show that? No, can you show that how to enter the URL where exactly?
Okay,
that would be more clear.
Here in security, you have to click on edit site list.
That is not visible. That more. That is not visible.
Yes, it's not moving, madam.
Yeah. We have a screen of Java 32 bit. After that, we don't have a.
Okay. It's not moving.
Okay. I have to share this.
And that is TM ready. Can you go?
Okay. Is it visible now?
Yes.
Here, you have to use, click on edit site list. Edit site list, and then you have to click on add.
Madam, kindly repeat, madam.
Okay, sir, 1 minute.
Yeah, kindly repeat.
Some screens are missed, ma'am. Please.
Okay. Just a minute, sir. Just a minute. Dr. Team ready. We kindly go to mute portion.
Under control panel, this is the option Java 32 bit. Okay.
Madam, this Java 32 bit will come after downloading the Mozilla. That's you said the 50.0.01, isn't it?
Yeah, after downloading Mozilla, and when you log in, and for the first time, you have to run that OXE file that it shows you to download.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, after that, it will be visible here. You have to click on Java 32 bit. You have to click on security.
Others, please mute your microphone, please.
Yeah, from your side, can you mute that TM ready? Monica, madam, you can mute him. Because that I'm not having that problem. Okay, please proceed. Yeah.
Okay. This is the screen visible where the option is edit site list.
Madam, in my system, I'm not getting this edit site list.
You are not getting edit site list.
Only manage certificates, it is there.
Manage certificates is there. Okay. Sir, I have to check that, but just we'll finish this. After that, I'll check it to AnyDesk.
Okay.
Exceptional
problems are there that can be checked through AnyDesk and later.
One more important thing is AnyDesk. That is the most important thing. That should be there in your system. Even if the ERP is not working on your system, we can still update the budget. Okay. Or we can address the issues. Okay, this screen is visible now where the option is edit site list is coming.
Yes.
Okay. Now, then you have to click on edit site list. This window will open up and here you have to click on add. When you click on add, there comes a new option and you have to just copy paste the URL of ICR ERP and save. Save, I mean, press on OK. Is that OK, sir?
Yeah, yes. Okay, madam.
Okay, sir. I'll close this. This thing you have to do after downloading the Mozilla, and then the ERP will work fine. Okay, and there is no need to update the Mozilla. Otherwise, it will again move to higher version, and the ERP will not work.
Okay.
Is there any issue in the project updation or creation? Yeah, okay, no. One more thing. Is there any issue regarding Java or anything there on the MIS FMS website? Let me just open it. Wait. Share the screen. Is the MIS FMS website visible?
Yeah, it's visible.
Yeah. On this website under FAQs. First part under general. How to solve Java related issues. Okay, with screenshots, there are steps you can update, use this document to update Java. If still there is any issue, you can drop a mail on helpdesk or you can call us. Okay.
Okay.
Apart from this, there are FAQs for project also, how to update the budget, how to create the project receipt, every kind of document is there with the screenshots. Okay. Same for finance, bill section, and same for HRMS for employee details, payroll, and for indent creation also. Okay, if there is any issue, you can use these documents. With screenshots, there are steps. If still there is any issue, you can drop a mail on helpdesk or you can call us, we'll help.
Very good. It is. I hope it is clear for all those who participated today. And any final questions, clarifications?
Raghu, if you can share your screen, she may help you.
I will try myself. Thank you, Monika ji. I will try. I will call you if I get any.
Sure, sir. Sure.
Yeah.
Ma'am, one question is there, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please.
Regarding paid up trials, what option we have to select? Whether it is consultancy contract or in what this one?
See, sir, this I cannot help. What type of paid up trial is for if. If there is any doubt for the type of project, the very first option, IIHR RPPI, is the very first option. You can select that for every project. That will work with every project.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, right.
Any other questions?
Madam, every year whenever this budget is getting extended now. Every year, if the project is getting extended, then we have to approach and then get the extension for that year, then only we can go for updating, right?
Yes, you can. You have to drop a mail. Otherwise, there is an option if you want to, if the institute want to utilize it, just let me show you it.
Okay, thank you.
No, I'll just, madam, one final question.
Yeah, that's it.
Madam, actually, there are some projects we do not know the end date.
Okay.
For example, we have a project from PPVFRA, even for that matter, AESRP projects.
Okay, I'll tell you that. But before that, the project extension, I'll tell you. One thing, you can mail us or you can call us. And the second thing is, when you click on IIHR projects, in the last, there comes the option project end date form.
Okay, madam. Yeah. Okay.
The PIs can fill this form. For example, I'll fill one. Wait. You have to put the new finish date. For example, I have to extend this till 2022. Okay. New finish date and reason of extension. For that, for example, you have got the new budget or whatever is the reason of extending. And then you have to click on submit for approval.
Okay.
PI has to click on. But here, this will go to the PME cell in charge of the institute.
Okay.
A notification will go to him. Once he approves that notification, the date will get extended. But for that, we you have to mail us the PME cells in charges ERP ID. We will add his ERP ID in the process, and after that, you can use this functionality.
Okay, madam. Okay, thank you, madam.
But this has some drawbacks because most of the PI says why do we need to get the permission from PME for externally funded projects? Because there the PIs are the whole sole, they have the whole sole responsibility of the project.
Yes.
Okay. For institute budgets, you can use this. For externally funded, you can mail us. We'll extend the date.
Okay, thank you.
And the second question was the date of the project you want to check.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, is the browser form visible to you?
Yes, madam.
Yeah.
Okay. When you click on IIHR projects, all these options will come on your browser form, and you have to click on project list under work plan. And when you click on project list, all the projects in your ERP ID, whether you are the PI or the co-PI, will display here, okay, with the project name. And here in the, this on the right-hand side, you can view its start date and project finish date. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sometimes the PI says the after extending the date of the project, they says the project date is not visible because they check for the same on project details from form where we created the project and enter the end date of the project for the first time while creating the new project. It does not get updated there. Once you have entered the date there, it remains there. The updated date can be will be visible here only under project list. Okay, sir. Is there any query regarding this?
It's fine, madam. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Okay. I hope this is the last question. Everybody is satisfied with very, very good presentation in a short span of time. Still, we are with us with that confidence. We from our IHR, we thank you very much for briefing us how to create budget and how to enter it in the new financial year. With this, all of us, we thank you very much for your patient answering also. This any training or exposure is meaningful only with the questions. I thank all the participants, which is helpful for not only for them and it's for the entire group. By thanking Monica, who will be ending this meeting. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Dr. Shridhar, it will be recorded. One will be shared with us.
Thank you. Okay. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all and be safe.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Monica. Well, because tonight. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. You can close the meeting.
Yeah.
Yeah.